You know, out of all the games I ever thought I'd ever record on this channel, Kingdom Hearts Birth by Sleep was one of them I thought I'd never get to. Greetings, I'm Solidus-Skully, and welcome to the Kingdom Hearts Birth by Sleep Final Mix Commentary. Yeah, this probably would have been uploaded a little bit sooner than, you know, I probably thought, but again, I wanted to make sure I got the Silent Hill Shattered Memories, which, time of recording has just been uploaded yesterday, so... Yeah, September heralds a new birth. A birth by sleep, if you will. And, by the way, the different modes allow you to get the different endings. You can unlock the... Well, okay, I'll talk about that later on because don't really have much time at the moment, but... Yeah, this correlates to what ending you get in Kingdom Hearts 2, though it isn't quite as stingy with the requirements. I believe you can actually unlock the secret ending on beginner mode if you so choose, but... like Kingdom Hearts 2, though, it's a bit of a pain in the ass, and we're not going to bypass tutorials because we need them! Well, relatively speaking, of course, I mean, I'm here to explain pretty much all the things that are going to be happening in the gameplay and story anyway, and, yeah, well, I mean, if Kingdom Hearts 2 was a bit of a litmus test as to just how anime-esque Kingdom Hearts could get and just how divisive the franchise could be, then Kingdom Hearts Birth by Sleep, again, if Days or Recoded wasn't enough of a jump into the deep end, this is pretty much going dick-first into the darkness! Yes, boy! I wonder why I'm doing this voice. Oh, it's settling in. But yes, you'll find out why I'm doing this voice soon, and twiddling my fingers that you cannot see. But yeah, this is what we worked so hard to unlock, which I didn't technically because I stole it from a YouTube video on the end of the Kingdom Hearts 2 commentary, but yeah, this is what you would have unlocked. I mean, you do get additional CGI scenes of our main trio here, but yeah. This also showcases a bit of the secret ending from Kingdom Hearts 2, so... Whoopsie doodles, but then again, it is sexy Square Enix CGI, and it is playing Simple and Clean, because this is the Kingdom Hearts 1 era, and Simple and Clean was the definitive theme, as Sanctuary was meant to be for the Kingdom Hearts 2 era, but they rarely have ever used Sanctuary, which makes me very sad, so look forward to more Sanctuary love if I ever get around to commentating over Kingdom Hearts Recoded and Dream Drop Distance, because I'm petty like that. But anyway, apart from basically being a foreshadowing of the events to come, this CGI sequence is, well, yeah. It kind of spoils the game of Birth by Sleep ahead of time, although it does give you a little bit more of a hint as to what things are going on, if you're one for looking at symbolic representation things. Basically, we have this old boar dude, Terra running through Castle Oblivion, and Ven running through Castle Morrowind. I don't know what that's actually called, it's just a symbol of... Then running between two different worlds, Ven running from the darkness and the explosion of light, and of course Terra running from the darkness. But yeah, I finally don't have to keep that guy's name a secret anymore, but yes, if you could no doubt tell by the bizarre Keyblade armor, yes, the unknown soldier, the lingering will, his name is Terra. And I wonder what's going to be happening to him. Is he going to become a Sith Lord? But yeah, things are gonna be very fucked up, and as you can no doubt tell with all our characters falling from the light... Yeah, the Birth by Sleep trio wasn't gonna have a happy ending, but don't worry, Sora and Riku are there to shatter the Station of Awakening and destroy the Heart of Glass. Ah, well, that's... kind of... weird. But anyway, it does have important relevance, because... Ventus... he's falling. Well, I call him Ventus, but he does look like Roxas. What is the reason for that? Well, we might just find out. And there's Sora and Riku, watching this kid just meteorite himself down to Earth, or wherever Destiny Islands is located. And speaking of Destiny Islands, we actually have a bit of a flashback to the earliest point of the Kingdom Hearts chronology. Well, sort of. It's kind of like midway between Union Cross and slightly before Dark Road. Dark Road does actually pick up immediately from this scene where, yeah... Seems this mysteriously familiar-looking figure has some dreams of grandeur. What a lovely sunset. But it's too bright.
This world is just too small.
There. You see, an empty world, like a prison. I imagine you will be right at home.
Who's there?
So yeah, to kind of cut in, sort of immediately really in detail what the hell's going on, the old dude right over there was Master Xehanort. Again, there's gonna be a lot of plot spoilers in the game going ahead, but to kind of differentiate him between the Xehanort we knew from Kingdom Hearts 2, I'm gonna be calling him Old Man Xehanort, and this little kid here is not in fact Roxas, but rather Ventus.
But why does he look like Roxas? And why does he have a frog in his throat like Old Man Xehanort? Well, we will find out soon, boy.
But yeah, basically, Ventus was being trained by Master Xehanort after some indistinguishable events between now and Union Cross, so, it seems he has finally regained the power to use the Keyblade, but what happened to him in the interim? Well, we're gonna be finding out, during the first couple of parts, actually, but, well, not the first couple of parts, the first segment of the story, because Birth by Sleep, as you will soon see, in part 2, actually has multiple stories. So the first one that we're going to be following on through is Ventus, then we're going to be following on from Aqua, and then finally Terra. And something else you're going to be noticing is how much it apes the familiarity of Kingdom Hearts 1 in some aspects.
A meteor shower!
So, welcome to the Land of Departure. Yes indeed, the mountains are in fact married. You know, they've been married a couple of times, I guess they believe in polygamy, I have no idea what the fucking term is, but
basically, they're the meteor shower invented of going, wow, I wanna go see it.
Even though it's past his bedtime, and no doubt the master of the castle will be very angry with him and want to smack his butt. Yes indeed, his butt! Oh, it's going to be very sore in the morning because he's, well, being naughty. And as we all know, naughtiness leads to darkness. And darkness leads to hate. And hatred leads to suffering. But yes, this is pretty much the gameplay of Birth by Sleep. Well, not necessarily good and proper, but it's similar yet different to the Kingdom Hearts you know. Again, you do have your basic jump, you can look around, you can use magic, you know, dodge roll, do all that kind of good stuff. But the setup of the whole game is a little bit different compared to what you're used to. Again, you do have your basic attack patterns. You're going to be seeing all this throughout, you know, the gameplay as an example, as Ventus beats up these training things. Yeah, never mind about the meteor shower, that's a once-in-a-lifetime event. Well, then again, Ventus is sort of a kid, except not really, because he existed like hundreds of thousands of years in the past, so whatever, we'll get to all that a little bit later. But basically, you can attack, get money, use magic, and all that kind of good stuff. Yes, the command style. Yeah, that's right, Ventus, you tell that playground equipment what for, but yes, this is also where the command deck comes into effect. In lieu of using, you know, your MP bar from the previous Kingdom Hearts games, instead you have, commands. Again, you basically slot them all into your command deck, so you have things like, as you can see here, again, you have the spell Arrow, which you can use to cast air magic, you can use Strike Raid, which is a command in and of itself, rather than an ability that you use by pressing either reaction commands or, you know, the specific item in your command slot. Again, it sounds a lot more complicated than it really is, but basically selects the command off in the little left-hand corner of the screen right there, and you can use a cool, super-powerful ability. It's not spammable, mind you, as you can see here with it charging up in orange. You're gonna wait for your commands to reload, so, yeah. You can't exactly take, like, the most biggest and badass powerful commands and go, oh yes, Ultima, blam, blah 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 blam, everybody's dead, and then use it multiple times. You're gonna wait for it to charge up, so it's, yeah, similar, yet a little bit different, and we will be getting into the command melding stuff thing a little bit later, but to kind of prelude my thoughts as to the command deck, oh, I'm very mixed on it. It does have its positive points, and again, I will say that in terms of the sort of spells and magic that you do get to use in Birth by Sleep compared to the rest of the series, you do get your hands on some pretty interesting spells, especially if you do take advantage of the command melding thing, as you're seeing right here. But a lot of its problems mainly come into it being, well, to kind of prelude my thoughts in the upcoming parts, basically being a five-step solution to a one-step problem. And that one-step solution to the five-step problem was already solved in Kingdom Hearts 1, so, yeah, we can't do anything with it for now, so I'll stay my tongue. That's me holding my tongue. I think I might have used that joke in a previous commentary. I think it might have been Batman Arkham Asylum, which I'm already recording at this point, and I'm already 12 parts in. So, yes indeed, much like the Batman, I prepare for everything. But yeah, this is pretty much just here to show all the basic Kingdom Heartsian elements here in play. It's just that now we have the command deck, which, well, again, to also give it a prelude, if I can kind of compare it to anything, it's something I kind of equate akin to the junction system of Final Fantasy VIII. Again, it sounds very complicated, but by the time you wrap your head around it, you can have a lot of fun with it, but at the same time, it is a sort of results may vary kind of thing where, well, your view on the whole thing might seem a little bit, again, it really depends on how you adapt to the command melding system and the command system in general, so yeah, I guess I won't really say much to right now, but right now Ventus needs to be asleep, so I guess a bit of quiet down. It's okay, Ventus, go to sleep, go back to sleep, go back to sleep. And yes, this is going to have a lot of keen parallels and they rhyme, they echo from the Star Wars prequels. Like this moment right here.
Whoa! Give me a break, Aqua.
Ven, you hopeless sleepyhead. You know, you should have at least brought a blanket.
But did I dream that place up? It really felt like I'd been there before, looking up at the stars.
Except you've always lived here with us.
That's what you think. But, yeah, respect your elders, Missy.
Hey, Aqua.
Hmm?
You ever wonder what stars are? Where light comes from?
Hmm. Well, they say
that every star up there is another world.
Huh? Oh.
Terra.
Yep. Hard to believe there are so many worlds out there besides our own. The light is their hearts. And it's shining down on us like a million lanterns.
What? I don't get it.
In other words, they're just like you, Ven.
What does that mean?
You'll find out someday, I'm sure.
I want to know now!
You're too young to know now.
Quit treating me like a kid!
Hey, what are you laughing at?
I can't help it. You two would make the weirdest brothers.
Huh?
We are friends. We are friends. We are friends. Oh god, this is so Attack of the Clones. But, yeah. I'm not making that reference idly either, because, Tetsuya Nomura basically saw Revenge of the Sith and thought, let's make a Kingdom Hearts version of that, except he wound up hitting more, well, Attack of the Clones.
Oh, yeah. Terra, you and I have our Mark of Mastery exams tomorrow. I made us good luck charms.
Wow.
Here.
I get one too?
Of course. One for each of us.
Yeah.
Somewhere out there, there's this tree with star-shaped fruit. And the fruit represents an unbreakable connection. So as long as you and your friends carry good luck charms shaped like it, nothing can ever drive you apart. You will always find your way back to each other. Technically, I think you're supposed to make them with seashells, but I did the best with what I had.
Boy, sometimes you are such a girl.
Hey, what do you mean sometimes?
So this isn't a real good luck charm?
Well, that's yet to be seen. But I did work a little magic on it.
Really? What?
An unbreakable connection.
And thus we have, binding ties, really. Again, much in the same vein as the Palpu fruit is meant to bind Sora and his root boyfriend Riku together. Yes, indeed, the Wayfinders is meant to bind the friendship of Aqua, Ventus, and Terra together. I wonder if that friendship will become corrupted. Oh, I only wonder. And this is a mechanic I'll talk about in a second. But first, cutscene.
Well, tomorrow's the exam. Anybody want to spar?
I can take you.
So yeah, while we won't be getting to D-Links in this episode, this is pretty much teaching you the basics of blocking and attacking or whatever, and also giving you a taste of each character you can select for a specific story, so here we're playing as Terra. Anyway, Dimension Links, otherwise known as D-Links, it's pretty much a facet of borrowing power from your friends, which is a mechanic that not a lot of people tend to utilize, but I've actually found to be incredibly useful, not only because of the fact that it gives you some very unique attacks based on specific characters you meet throughout the game, characters original to Kingdom Hearts, Final Fantasy characters, and Disney characters themselves, but again, you also get some unique attacks, which you'll be finding out a little bit later, as well as a few unique abilities if you level up D-Links, because, leveling up, that's something you're going to be doing a lot of in this game, and oh dear god, the grinding, the grinding! Yeah, I had to do a lot of grinding for this game just to kind of preface this ahead of time, but, it does kind of run into a bit of a Sonic Heroes problem in the sense that, you remember how you had to level up, you know, the character-specific levels in Sonic Heroes? Well, imagine not just doing that for the characters' levels, you know, in an RPG sense of traditional Kingdom Hearts, but imagine if you also had to level up individual commands, and leveling up your individual abilities such as high jump, air dash, and stuff like that, but also leveling up, you know, your D-links, leveling up your penis level, leveling up your shot locks, leveling up your anal passageways. Yeah, this is the shot lock, by the way. Really useful ability, actually, because Aqua's pretty much like, I'll spray bubbles on you. Which is actually a rather... Well, I guess it's meant to be the series utilizing water magic, but yeah, it never really gets to that stage until Kingdom Hearts 3, surprisingly enough. But yeah, this is pretty much giving you a taste of combat and your various abilities, so I'll get into a lot of my bitching complaints next time, because yeah, Birth by Sleep is a game that I'm very mixed on. It has its positive points, but at the same time though, there's just a lot about Birth by Sleep that frustrates me, so yeah, I'll try my best not to make this whole game is literally so bad I'd stick my dick in a chainsaw sort of diatribe, but yeah, let's just say there's going to be a lot to talk about, and hopefully it'll be enough for the three stories, because yeah, as you can no doubt tell with the Rashomon effect, revisits to specific worlds will be in order, and whether or not I run out of commentary, that will be the sticking point. But in the meantime, let's call it a night and go to sleep.
Trust me, you guys are ready. You're gonna clean up at the exam tomorrow.
I hope it's that easy.
It's like the Master said. Power is born within the heart. When the time is right, you just need to look inside yourself, and you'll find it there.
Yeah. Get ready to hear a lot of flowery, prequel Jedi-esque dialogue from Aqua, Terra, and even Ventus to some extent, but... Yeah, that kind of elicits a bit of an issue with their characters in that they don't tend to be quite as relatable as, say, you know, Sora, Kairi, and Riku. Well, I don't know. We'll get into a lot of these characters, and I'm going to be tackling them for the most part individually, depending on their story, but, yeah, it's going to be a painful ride, so, on that note, I'm Solidus-Skully, keep it new metal, and next time on the Kingdom Hearts Birth by Sleep commentary... Yes, we're gonna be in for pain. Catch you next time.
Hey, we're gonna head back.
Yeah, me too. Together. Always.
That would be the last night we ever spent beneath the same stars.